Oh, here, how the heck are you this fine day? Me? I'm feeling somewhat patient. I'm feeling patient with my channel because I want to talk today about length of video. How much patience do your viewers have? And what's the perfect length of video for you to be producing? Topic came up, and it comes up on a regular basis. And there used to be a school of thought in YouTube, and it still is to a certain extent, that shorter is better, that a 2-minute video is going to perform better than a 3-minute video, which is going to perform better than a 4-minute video. And there is some truth to that for a lot of different types of content. But you have to consider that you know your content better than anybody. And they have this new term, they call them an avatar. Maybe it's not a new term, it's new to me. An avatar, that's your perfect, your ideal customer or viewer. Who is that person? I'm pretty sure it's you. For your channel and me for my channel. The things that we're interested in, that we're compelled with, that we will stay with, are the things that our viewers tend to be interested in with and tend to be compelled with. So you have to kind of use yourself. I would anyways use myself as a measuring stick. Now, having said that, we are mostly all in love with the sound of our own voice. So not taking advantage of that situation and saying, wow, I was witty there, I was fun there, and stretching out your video beyond its useful length, its most useful length, is probably not the healthiest thing. So what's really required to determine what the optimal length of video is for each of us is a second opinion. Where do we get a second opinion? We get a second opinion from our YouTube analytics. Come with me on a brief journey into YouTube analytics. So I'm going into the analytics button here in our analytics area within my channel. And the report that we want to generate right now is this one called audience retention. Let's click on that and let's take a look at how my channel is performing. So we start with a very global look, and then we can get more nuclear and granular as we look at each individual video. And hopefully by looking at how people stay with those videos and when they stop watching the videos, we can learn what's working best for us. And oh, look at this. Steve's videos are awesome because look at their improvement. Look at how they're increasing from averaging under 6 minutes per view to over 6 minutes per view, all in the space of 28 days. Steve must be amazing. He must be doing a great job. I can hear you all saying and thinking. In truth, these numbers this month are a little bit of an anomaly as far as I'm concerned, because this month I decided to, in the last couple of weeks, you can see when I did it, right, a couple of weeks ago here, is I took a bunch of webinars that I produced over the years that I was using as lead capture for email, and I decided to release those just as webinars that people can watch. And they're all over an hour long, and I think there's 3 of them that I released. And some of them have gotten some pretty good traction and some pretty good viewership. But now, all of a sudden, instead of watching my normal 6 to 12 minute videos, people are watching 1 hour videos. So naturally, my minutes viewed is climbing. Commensurate with my minutes viewed climbing, my percentage viewed is plummeting. It's at 40%. That's the number I look at first. Not necessarily the number of minutes, but the percentage of my video watched. And I like to keep it around 50%. But I'm not too distraught right now, because with an hour video, people can watch it for 20 minutes, which is a pretty good kick at the can, and they're still going to only be registering at 33% of it viewed. So my percentage is going to drop with these long videos that I just released. I'm not too distraught. I'm a wee bit distraught, I will say, just because my ego's taken a bit of a bruising. But so these numbers are not, I'm not going to make decisions based on what I'm seeing this month. Previously, I was hovering 49, 50, 51% on my video views. That's kind of been my threshold, and I'm comfortable with that. I am striving to increase it, and I'll show you how I'm looking at those stats as we go on. So that's our overall channel. Have a look at that. Get a feel for how long your videos are being watched. Mine on average of 5 minutes and 40 seconds. That's a good start. So I know that I don't have to concentrate. For my content, I know that 3 minutes, I don't need to worry about that, because I know people are staying with me for at least double that. And that could be because I add a little bit of edutainment to my videos. I try and be a little bit humorous. Occasionally my dog or my cat does something which I leave in the video, which makes them long, which people seem to enjoy. Or I am just so compelling. But at any rate, I'm managing to hold people for at least 5.5 minutes or so per video. That's at a global level. If we take a look granularly at each video, we can see my best performing video is only averaging 39% viewed, but it still does well as far as minutes. It's a little bit of a longer video on my 5 favorite Evernote features. So that's the one that's performed best. over the last month. Look at that. I got 39%. I got 44%. I got this one. This one here, going paperless with Evernote, 25%. See, that's one of the webinars that I just released. A lot of minutes, 17 minutes on average, but only 25% of it viewed. That's bringing some numbers down while pushing other ones up. It's kind of ironic, isn't it? So looking through, you can then, what you should be doing is you should be examining videos that you have an idea of how you structured them, and then looking at how your audience responded. So here's one that I actually worked hard on. Let me find it here. It is, and it's on a Google Forms. This is a what I consider to be a pretty good video because I was taking on a topic that a lot of people don't explore, Google Forms, and I did a pretty good tutorial on it. I actually re-recorded this one two or three times, which is more than I normally do. I normally one take and I'm done. I recorded it two or three times, but it's only performing at 43% percentage viewed. But it's getting a lot of comments. The people who are viewing it are liking it. So it's an interesting one to look at. So if we just click on the video itself, it'll bring up the audience retention stats for this video for the last 28 days. And let's just pause it. So you know what? And I can actually change that term. Oh, I would have had to do it in the previous menu. So we'll just leave it. So in the last month, look at this. It doesn't do very well right at the beginning, does it? Like 30 seconds into it, I've already dropped off to 77% of the audience. So I've lost 23% of my audience in the first 30 seconds. To be honest, that's not all that unusual. You are going to have a pretty precipitous drop off right at the beginning, or at least my style of video is going to have that. I don't know if all videos are like that, but my style of video, because people just make a decision really quick. They, you know, it's not what they thought or whatever reason. So we do have a quick drop off. Now you have to be careful that you don't have too precipitous a drop off because that hurts your YouTube ranking a lot. YouTube only counts videos that last over 30 seconds. Views that are over 30 seconds. When people drop away at the beginning, first of all, they don't count as views. But secondly, if you have too many count doing that, YouTube is going to say your video is not very representative of what the title is or something like that. So they're probably going to penalize you as far as search goes, which is going to hurt your ranking. So you do want to be careful and you want to pay attention to that. Once the video actually started rolling, and I started getting into the demo part, which is right here. And look at this. I was playing with formats. Do you remember when I was back playing with formats? And here I was playing with an idea that I could stack all of my different links of things to do, like subscribe to my channel and support us on Patreon, in this little stack. And then I'd perch my head on the top. And all it is I look like a gigantic Pez dispenser, don't I? Forgot about that. Okay. Not my finest moment, graphically speaking and design-wise. I will give you that. And that could be something to do with it. But right about here, we're still at 70%. Now we suddenly drop off. And we drop off to 55% in the space of 1 minute here. Look at that. We drop off. That's a minute later there in the video right there. And we've dropped off from 70% down to 56%. So we've dropped off 14 points right there. So that's the kind of most precipitous drop in it. And what am I doing at that point? So what I'll do is I'll go in and I'll watch the video at that point.
A form.
And I'll see exactly what I'm doing and try and figure it out. Now, I recognize that this content is a little drier than some other content. And I'm hoping that that's the reason that the drop-off has happened. But there's another thing that I look for when I look at these shapes, these forms that are my audience retention. And this is the, look at this. I have a valley here, 40% at 5 minutes in. But look at me at 7 minutes in, 42%. How could that be? If people left the video, how are they back? The reason that they're back is they're the same people, but they've rewound the video because they want to see it again for some reason. So these are opportunities for you to look at the content that people are finding valuable because they're repeating it. Either you're not explaining it well, you're stumbling, maybe you didn't do a good job on your screenshots, or that's the type of compelling content that people really like and they want to listen to it again because it's so darn valuable. So these are opportunities for you to look at the shape of your audience retention and then be able to start to read the tea leaves a little bit to figure out how it works. So that's number one. This shape here, not overly happy with that shape of, you know, that big drop and only being at 40%. Mind you, once I got into the base content where I was actually doing the demo, look at how I retained people from the 4 minute mark all the way right through to when I started probably talking about, doing my rap where I was encouraging people to subscribe and stuff. All the way through there, we stayed within a percentage or two. So this, the meat of the content, once we got people into this video, was still good. And I know that this video is well received, maybe not numerically, but it gets a lot of comments. And it gets an awful lot of comments and discussion and a lot of thank yous in the YouTube channel, in the YouTube conversations, in the chat area. So I'm not surprised to see that flatline. If I saw just a continued decline all the way down, a nice steady decline, your content, you there's nothing about your content that's super compelling. People just keep waiting for it to get better, and it doesn't get better, and then they eventually leave. So that's one form. Let's take a look at one other video that I've got here, and let's look at one that's performed a lot better. So that one's performed only at 43% average viewed, was that Google Forms. Let's find one that's performed better. And look here. This is one that I've just released this month. Sketch. What is so good about Sketch? 67%. It's a very similar length video, and it's just another tool that I show. So let's take a look at the shape that the audience retention takes in that. And again, I've got a
Steve
precipitous
Dotto here.
Drop.
How the heck?
I'm also very orange in this one. A precipitous drop right off the beginning, and let's see, at 30 seconds in, look at that. We're actually 10% higher 30 seconds in. We were at 70% here. We're at 80% here. So the content, this tells me that the content, because my launch getting into the video is pretty similar in each case, so this content is just more engaging. People are more interested in this graphics tool than they are in a forms tool. Fair enough. I can see that. But again, look, it stayed nice and flatlined all the way through, red at 70%. And again, we had a bump. So if we take a look at what happened here in the video, it, from there to there, I see what happened is I was talking about resources and how much I was talking about my computer's resources at that point. So people are interested in that technical side. And look, it actually jumped a couple of points from 73%, I think I saw 75. Yeah, it jumped a couple of points. So people, a fair number of people rewound this section. So that is really good and compelling information. And then once we reach the very end, and I bet you if I listen,
screen capture and
right at this point here,
and annotation,
the music will come
utility.
In.
I think it's a 2 thumbs up.
There it is.
App.
I give thumbs up. I give thumbs up. Made it obvious that I was at the end of the valuable content, and now I was into my pitching you to sign up for my subscription things and become a subscriber to my channel and give me money on Patreon. I was about to do all of that stuff, and look, boop, people left. This is gold as we start to read it. I don't think you'll ever get out of looking at this a hard and fast rule of this is the way I have to do it, but instead this is the maturation process of your channel. Paying attention to what works, what doesn't work, slowly over time you'll gain an appreciation for what's going to resonate with your audience, what's not, and things that you can do hopefully to tweak those numbers up. Because we can't do really A-B testing with this sort of a video, at least not for most of us, for our channels. So it's basically we just have to look at two videos, similar content that are performing quite a bit differently, and try and figure out what it is in those videos that is different. In this case here, I think it comes mainly down to the fact that the drier content, which just has less engagement, the fact that forms aren't as interesting as screen capture and drawing arrows and graphics, I'm hoping that that is the difference, because really those two videos are quite similar, other than the fact that I was sitting on a Pez dispenser in the one. But these numbers going into the audience retention will help you determine best length of video, how to retain your audience, which means that each of your videos, if you retain a higher percentage, your videos are ranked higher in YouTube. Conversely, they're going to be ranked higher in addition, they will be ranked higher in YouTube and Google, and you'll have better audience engagement. Your channel will grow as a result. That's it. I hope that you found this to be enlightening and useful. There's three ways that you can stay in touch with us here on Dotto Tech. First, of course, please subscribe to our channel. Subscribe to this channel. Secondly, sign up for our newsletter. I send it out once a week minimum, which includes all of our videos plus notice of any upcoming webinars that we have. And we do some great webinars here at Dotto Tech. And finally, Dotto Tech is a community-funded site through Patreon. If you don't know what Patreon is all about and you don't understand the patron model on the internet, have a look at my Patreon page. Basically, instead of getting corporate sponsorship, I ask you folks to carry the freight a little bit as far as the cost of maintaining this channel, and for as little as $1 a month, you can become one of our Patreon patrons. You get some perks, I get some security, and a lot of love flows back and forth, and we all like that. With that, I'm going to say that's it for today. I'm Steve Dotto. Have fun storming the castle.